I want you to meet a new guy what's going to be with us. This is,
Cesar Enrico Bandello.
Oh, little Cesar, huh?
Yeah, sure.
That's him. That's little Cesar. That sneering, sick, vicious little guy. Edward G. Robinson was a major movie star for 40 years, in all kinds of roles, but nobody ever forgot Little Caesar. Nobody ever stopped thinking of him as a gangster, and personally, I know what that's like. No matter how many movies I make, how many things I do, when people think of Chaz Palminteri, they think of A Bronx Tale or Bullets Over Broadway, the gangsters. I guess in a way, that's what draws me to Edward G. Robinson. That and the fact that we both started out on the stage, in live theater. But all that goes away when I watch him. That's when I see the sheer force of his personality. The way this little guy could take over a movie and make you believe.
I want you to wake up in the night and see your own squashy, putrid little soul. I want you to know that every human being that works for you knows what a diseased hypocrite you are. We all know what you are, but we take your money and do your work because we're afraid to starve.
You'll have my resignation and release of my contract on your desk immediately.
But, Randall, don't
get
be
out.
Hasty. But,
Randall... Get out!
When you're an actor and you see a performer like that, you say, yes, that's what I want to do. In a movie, you might get only 4 or 5 scenes, and you want to make an impression. When Edward G. Robinson is on screen, you want him to stay there. When he's not, can't wait till he comes back.
He'd give you a left eye to nail me, wouldn't you? Huh? You can see the headlines, can't you?
Yeah.
Well, listen, Hick. I was too much for any big city police force to handle. They tried, but they couldn't.
When I talk about him, I start out saying Edward G. Robinson this, Edward G. Robinson that. By the next sentence, I'm calling him Edward G. and then forget it, it's Eddie. Like I know the guy. But that's just the point. Eddie reaches the audience in a way that ordinary actors can't. Look at Little Caesar. All through the movie, he's a psychopath, right on the edge, scary like nobody in the movies had ever been before. But the key scene is when he cracks. He's got to shoot his best friend, but he loves the guy, and he just can't do it.
Shoot, Rico.
I look at Eddie here, and I see anguish. Not just weakness, but despair. Every bit as real as the anger. Watch him play both emotions. That takes so much talent to show rage and love simultaneously. The thing that Eddie has is honesty. He's always real and in the moment. I remember the Seawolf. He plays a ship's captain, a power-mad intellectual, nothing like Little Caesar, but just as convincing. Look in his eyes. Look at his heart. He's always right there.
My strength justifies me, Mr. Van Wyden. The fact that I can kill you and let you live as I choose. The fact that I control the destinies of all on board the ship. The fact that it's my will and my will alone that rules here.
When you have that kind of power, movies start to revolve around you. Even in a great film like Double Indemnity, in a small role, Eddie becomes the conscience of the movie, the moral center. It's like a clock running through the film, the one guy you follow, the one who keeps the movie grounded.
Warner, I'm a very great man.
Yeah?
This Dietrichson business. It's murder. And murders don't come any neater. Smart, tricky, almost perfect. But I think Papa has it all figured out. Figured out and wrapped up in tissue paper with pink ribbons on it.
I can show you a million examples, but there's no way a few clips can do justice to Eddie's career. You have to watch the movies to see the way he changes his style over the years. He wasn't always a tough guy. He wasn't always intense. He did great comic variations on his gangster character. No matter what Eddie does, it just can't help loving the guy.
You're the only one who was ever in my life and ever will be.
I'm sorry, baby. I think I know how you feel. And I'm going to give you a chance to prove it.
How?
You love me?
Oh, do I?
Put that rope around my legs, will you? My ankles are getting cold.
Some people say that as an actor, you put a mask on. I've never believed that, and I don't think Eddie did either. I think we take masks off and find characters inside ourselves. I came across something Eddie wrote about acting. This tells you how seriously he took the job. These are his words. Every one of us bears within him the possibility of all passions, all destinies of life in all its manifold forms. Nothing human is foreign to us. That's what an actor has to do. Reach for every possibility, every human passion. If you want to see how it's done, let me recommend Eddie, Edward G. Robinson. For Turner Classic Movies, I'm Chaz Palminteri.
Edward G. Robinson holds hostages in a hurricane in Key Largo, Thursday at 10:15 a.m., part of TCM's March Malice.